such thing as a light that's better than yours. No such thing as a light that's better than yours. No such thing as a light that's better than yours. No such thing, no such thing. Heart beating fast, let a nigga know that he alive. Fake niggas, mad snakes, snakes in the grass, let a nigga know.
What's going on? What's going on, people, man? My name's Ian Johnson, a.k.a. ENJ is what I go by. And this is the first of many vlogs to come. I have been stating that I wanted to, you know, do a vlog for the longest, like, you know, for the last couple of years. But I didn't really have the courage to, you know, just get out there and go for it. So I finally, you know, just... you know, put my foot down and said, I'm gonna make this thing happen, and that's exactly what I'm doing. So, kind of what you can expect from this blog, I'll be discussing, you know, a couple of topics, sports, mainly basketball and football. Definitely, I love those sports. I'm diehard fans of those two sports, so I'll be doing a lot of vlogging in regards to, you know, my opinion in those sports, and you know what I feel is going to take place in those areas. Also, I'm real big on entrepreneurship, so I'll be discussing, you know, a lot of entrepreneurship, like the mindset, you know, ways to turn your passion into profit. You know, try to you know, give back as much as I possibly can. So that's one going to be one of the you know, the topics I talk about. So just mainly basketball, football, and entrepreneurship is kind of the subjects that most of my vlogs are going to discuss. I'm also going to be vlogging my journey as well, because right now I feel like I'm on my road to riches. I'm trying to take my life to that next level. So I just, you know, I'm gonna put it on camera and, you know, let you guys take the trip with me. Just to let you know a little bit about myself. I was born and raised in Dallas, Texas. You know, hence the jersey. I'm a diehard Cowboys fan all day long. I'm really loving, you know, our new trio. So, you know, I think I got big hopes and, I think we're going to, you know, really make some real noise this year. And I think we're going to finally get back to that Super Bowl and, you know, do the thing, you know. And I'm willing to debate anybody on that topic. You know, I love my boys. I'm also a diehard LeBron James fan, man, against the hat that was in the corner. Right now they're in the playing for in the championship. So, you know, I think I'm excited, man. I think that they can still come back at some things they're going to have to, you know, work on, like the defensive side of the ball. And, you know, hopefully they can come back and make this thing a challenge. You know what I'm saying? So that's just kind of – I kind of got a little off topic, but I just wanted to make sure that I let you know that it's Cowboys Nation all day, and LBJ is the king. He's that guy. But just to get a little bit back on topic – I was born and raised in Dallas, Texas. So in my early days, I was heavily into sports. You know, basketball and football, those were my favorite sports. I was, you know, like the star on the teams, you know, in elementary. And when I got to junior high, my first year in junior high, the seventh grade year, I got like a shock because with the team, like in seventh grade, I was like, came off the bench, I guess you could say. I wasn't really looked at as a star anymore, and that was a eye-opening experience. It was like one of those awakening calls. Seventh grade, I mean, I played, I got my PT, but I wasn't accustomed to the limited amount of time I was getting. Then I got to eighth grade, and that's when I got my shine on again. When, you know, I was one of the stars on the squad at that time. And then going up into high school, I ended up quitting football because my athletic director, he tried to make me choose between football and basketball. And to be honest, I mean, I loved basketball. Like, that was my sport. And we were a football program because, of course, we're here in Texas. So it was a football program was like what they were known for. So they would try to, you know, get people to, you know, get you to just stick with one sport. So I wanted to play basketball too. So I just ended up quitting football, going straight basketball. Didn't really pan out the way that I wanted it to. You know, I was one of those guys that was JV. You know, sophomore in junior year. I mean, I was the guy on the team. I was still, you know, the star on the team those years. But, you know, it wasn't really saying much considering I was on JV, I guess you could say. But I really enjoyed the game. And just the fact that I was able to play, you know, was good. I feel like I had the talent. What I didn't have was the work ethic. I didn't understand the work ethic that was needed in order to really strive in any sport. I didn't I had never been sat down and had that explained to me. Had it happened, you know, I think I could have went a lot higher as far as the level that I played at. So I definitely think I would have played in college. I would have had a collegiate opportunity, no matter how low, like JUCO, college, or D2 or something of that nature. That was kind of, you know, my journey of growing up. Senior year, I was on varsity, but I rode the bench. so it wasn't anything special. I really started losing the love for the actual game, like as far as, you know, I didn't really want to go to practice, things of that nature. I had started working a job, so I was more into going to work to get, you know, get some money, keep some money in my pocket. But I still love basketball. I watch it all the time, basketball and football. And, you know, I debate about everything, and I have an opinion on, you know, in every scenario. But fast forwarding, not necessarily fast forwarding, but getting back to the topic. Senior year I rode the bench. I ended up graduating in 2007 from Lake Highlands High School, and from there I went off to college. I went to Clark Atlanta University, which is in Atlanta, Georgia. So I spent 6 years out there, and that was a real great experience for me, because that was like my actual first time, you know, being outside of Dallas. Like, prior to going to school, the only thing that I really knew was Dallas. Like, I didn't even really get, you know, fully grasp the concept or idea, you know, that it's a lot bigger world out here than just this little area that I'm in. So that really opened my eyes up to that, and I've been to several states since then. So that was definitely a great experience. However, I did not graduate from school. I'm not ashamed of that or anything like that. I actually dropped out after, like, I was 5 years in. And I really wasn't into school. I felt like I was just wasting a lot of time and a lot of money. And I just feel like it was time for me to step back from school and stop wasting that time and money. Also around this time, I had read a book by Robert Kiyosaki, Rich Dad, Poor Dad. I'm not sure if you've ever read it. If you haven't, you definitely wanna read that book. It's a great book. I read that book around the same time that I dropped out of school, and that book really opened up my mind, you know, because in prior to that, the only way that I knew of to make money was by getting a job, pretty much, you know, going and working a 9-to-5, and you know, that was the only way I knew of making money. And once I read that book, he like challenged, you know, all of the popular popular dogma that was out there, like go to school, get good grades, graduate so you can get a good job, and you know, live a good life, hopefully. And you know, I've seen that formula, you know, work out in my parents' life and, you know, friends' life and everything. And it, you know, they didn't seem, well, let me put it like this: they were not in the position that I wanted to be in, right? So by reading that book, he opened up my mind, and it made me see that I don't necessarily have to go to school in order to be successful to reach the levels that I'm trying to, you know, the levels that I'm trying to reach, the level of success that I'm trying to reach. So once I read that, man, it gave me that confidence to just go ahead and actually leave school behind without, you know, without feeling like a failure, without feeling like I'm not going to be able to make it out here in this world. So that book really changed my life, and I really, you know, encourage anybody, you know, who's trying to, you know, take their life to the next level, just don't know how, to read that book, man, because it's gonna definitely work on your mindset. But back on the subject, excuse me, back on the topic. So yeah, I lived out there for 6 years. Like I said, I dropped out of college my fifth year in college, second semester. Just said, hey, I'm done with it. And at the same time, I actually got a sales job, door-to-door sales job, working with AT&T, doing AT&T Uverse. So this job was another learning experience in my life because, you know, as I mentioned, I read that book, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, and there was a statement, you know, in there that really, you know, altered my thinking. It was a fact in there that said 76% of self-made millionaires started off in sales. So once I read that, it was like, hey, you know, I want to be a millionaire. So, you know, maybe it's something about this sales game that I need to know. So I ended up getting a sales job, and I did that door-to-door. I did that for about a year. I didn't become, like, you know, elusive. I didn't become like elite in it, but I definitely learned a lot within that year's time because I worked strictly off commission. So it really taught me the principles of entrepreneurship and how to, you know, how to go about handling yourself from making straight commission. So instead of being paid on the hourly wage, I got paid for, you know, the actual work that I put in. So that work ethic, no, that kind of, you know, got instilled in me, like, hey, I gotta go out here and put this work if I want to get paid. So that was definitely a eye-opening experience. So then I ended up moving back home. Things kind of, you know, fell through in Atlanta, so I ended up moving back home, and now I'm here, and now I'm back home. So that's just a little brief synopsis of my life and my story. I definitely go a lot more detail at a later, you know, at a later time in later vlogs. So you definitely want to tune in for those. So you know, you can know, I'll be telling you the details of, you know, each experience that I had. But I just wanted to first just introduce myself. So, you know, you guys, you know, I'm put out there. So my name again is Ian J. It's my name. And I'll be bringing a lot more vlogs to you. So just be on the lookout. Be sure to subscribe to my page if you want to get the latest videos from me, as well as like this video and go check out my website. It's roadtogreatness.org. That's R-O-A-D, the number 2, greatness.org. Okay, so go check that out. But that's all I have for you right now. So until next time, three fingers up, drop the ring one, I'll holler.